Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to talk about one report uploaded on Association of Mutual Funds in India website. Actually this website has so many information and resourceful website it is. I will cover this website in another video. Okay, today I am going to talk about and show you the highlight of this report, that is industry trends of mutual fund industry for last 1 year. Starting from November 17 to November 18. This is actually a small good report, actually 6 pages. I thank Amfi for bringing out such small and good information report, which gives the overall trend of the market. Okay, this report and these findings will help you to get overall understanding of the mutual funds in India and accordingly create your opinion and bias towards the correct opinion. Okay, it is showing the investment in or total asset under management in mutual funds, that was around 22.73 trillion. That is really a big amount. So it started to grow and it peaked in around August 2018 to 24.70 trillion. It was the highest point of the bull market running in the market. Nifty was also at highest point around this time. So later on market suddenly slumped into bearishness, and then the overall investment was drawn out of the market, and it now reduced to, on November 18 it was 23.59 trillion. So it is around 0.8 to 1 trillion above compared to last year. This is first page, okay, that shows overall investment, and second page shows scheme wise composition of assets. Okay, so this chart actually basically shows four scheme wise breakup of the total asset. First is debt oriented schemes, like into the bonds and all. Okay, second is equity oriented, that mostly 60 to 80% invest in directly equity shares. Okay, third is ETFs and fund of funds, that basically invests in index funds and in the funds that invest in other funds, that is FOF, called as fund of funds. Okay, and fourth one is liquid or money market, that is short term, you can call short term debt instruments or bond, you can call it. It has validity of only overnight validity to 90 to 180 days around. Okay, so it basically shows, earlier it was highest was equity oriented schemes, and that was around total participation was 38.4%, and then it started to grow and then continuously growing to 42%. Actually it has gained share from this dark color Persian blue, that is debt oriented schemes, that were 39% and now it is reduced to 29.6%. So debt oriented investments are reducing through mutual funds in India by investors, and they are increasing in liquid fund, that is from 19% it increased to 24%, and also in equity oriented fund remaining around constant. Okay, now third page shows investor type composition of mutual fund assets. Basically this is classified into individual, that is retail kind of investor, and another one is HNIs and all other high net, that is institutional investors you can call. Okay, so it was around it has remained nearly same, or okay, and only individual investors has grown from 48% to now 54%, and institutional investors have decreased from 51 to 46%. So you can consider it as around equal. Okay, now the fourth page shows investor categories across scheme types. First is here one important point to note is that individual investors are major in equity oriented schemes, and institutional investors are major in liquid or debt oriented money market, not debt oriented exactly, money market or liquid market funds. So you can deduce one conclusion that institutional investors are not taking risk through mutual fund investment. So they are investing mostly in liquid funds, and individual investors are taking more risk through mutual funds. They are exposing to risk through mutual funds, that is equity oriented schemes. In debt oriented we have seen it is around same, near about 54-46, and in ETF if you see institutional investors are more. So ETFs are basically investing in gold ETF and then index funds and all. So you can see institutional investors are investing more in liquid and money market and funds which are less volatile into nature. Okay. Fifth page is composition of investor holdings. Here the same thing is reflected. For institutional investors, liquid funds are 45% and 35% is debt oriented schemes, okay, and ETFs also. And equity oriented schemes are very lower or small in institutional investors holding mutual fund. And for individual, they are more into equity oriented schemes, that is directly into the shares or equities, and 25% into debt oriented, that is smaller portion of their investment. And very least are invested in ETFs and fund of funds through mutual funds. And 6% are in liquid. They are keeping less money liquid through mutual fund. Okay. And the last page that shows overall growth in the assets. Okay, in the last 1 year, institutional investors have decreased in total asset. Okay, they from 11 lakhs they have reduced to around 10 lakhs. Okay, crores. And for individual investor, there's a growth noted into it, that is from 11 lakh to it is 12 lakh they have increased. So overall investment in mutual fund is increasing, but institutional investors are reduced a slight and individual investors are increased. Okay, so these are few pages of this report. It was around 6 page report, a small overall trend showing report of a mutual fund. Okay, this is from Amfi site, that is Association of Mutual Funds in India. It is a website of Association of Mutual Funds in India. Okay, and it is a very resourceful and helpful website. You can check it out. I will also cover it in my any video. Okay, one more thing I want to tell. Okay, below my video, if you are accessing through PC or through mobile, you can click on the subscribe button to subscribe to my channel, or you can click on like and dislike. And important thing is that if you click on the share button, you will get a link which you can share on Facebook, WhatsApp, and wherever you want to share. Okay, and recently I created one video on VIX, that is volatility index in India, also covering basic highlights of Rank MF website and all. If you have any query and if you have any opinions about my videos and overall thing that you want to share with me, please comment below my video. Thank you very much for listening, Share Market Friend.